These folks are busy making pie. Lots of pie.
You look out on the street and you will see hundreds of people running around with their forks raised in their hand. It involves over 45 or 50 businesses, over 100 volunteers. Everybody gets into it. People are happy. They're eating pie.
Why these pie-crazed hordes? It's time for Rockland's annual Pies on Parade, which takes place in January around National Pie Day. Hundreds of people pay $30 a ticket, stopping at select venues to sample every imaginable kind of pie.
What's a better way to spend a day on a Sunday afternoon than eating pie? You can enjoy...
Cheryl Mickelson runs the Berry Manor Inn, a 12-bedroom B&B. Cheryl is proud of this immaculately kept historic house with its fine original details. But she's prouder to be co-founder of Pies on Parade. It's a huge fundraiser for the area Interfaith Food Pantry.
The AIO Food Pantry, it is the only one in the county that also does food and fuel assistance, so it serves a wide number of people.
In December 2016 alone, the pantry served more than 1,300 people in Knox County. One in five children here lives in poverty.
Maine has a lot of food insecurity because of its rural nature. So you have a lot of kids that don't get three meals a day. You have families. They serve 650 families a week.
100% of the Pies on Parade proceeds goes to the pantry. More than $150,000 raised since the event launched in 2003. The Granite Inn and the Lime Rock Inn are co-founders.
The inns all absorb the cost of marketing, of the posters, of everything. Everybody donates all their food, all their product.
As Edwin Hance of the Granite Inn whips up his blueberry pie.
Now, did you cook pies?
Oh, we did. We did.
Lime Rock Inn owner Frank Izgonitis shows us one of his specialties.
We are making pizza rustica, which I grew up referring to as Easter pie because that was the time of year that we ate it. And typically, Mom made these pies on Good Friday night when we were fasting.
Frank starts with a sweet pastry crust.
And then we combined all great things Italian on the inside.
He's talking ricotta cheese, egg, pecorino, and mozzarella, and three kinds of meat.
There's a traditional ham, there's prosciutto, and then there's mortadella, which I would call, for layman folks, an Italian version of bologna. We'll allow the steam to escape. We are ready to go.
It looks great.
The event is exhausting for organizers and volunteers, but totally worth it, says Cheryl.
It makes you feel good. As much as your feet ache and you're tired and pie becomes a four-letter word, it's hard to complain when you know what your effort's going to go to. Because one ticket feeds a family of four for 5 days.